Hey guys, this is Oscar Moon and welcome to Code Vein. This is going to be a Let's Play series. Hope you're going to enjoy it. I know I am, hopefully, anyway. We did miss just a few seconds of the intro here, but that was only like the camera zooming in from the sky down to the town, so no problem. Okay, what is that? That's like a lifestone of sorts. Alright, here we go. Alright, can we press any button here? Adjust the brightness so that only the image on the left is visible. Yeah? I'm gonna go that. What do you mean, until the installation is complete? Alright, let's go offline then. I'm gonna auto-switch that. Guard, parry. Oh, guard, parry, same. Dash combo, open gift menu. Strong attack, weak attack, dodge, hold. Okay. Let's go! Code Vein! Man, I'm not sure why I couldn't go online. I am online because I just downloaded this game. Took me about 5 minutes because it's very early here in Sweden, so I'm probably the only one using the internet. But yeah, so it should be online.
Search your memory for an image of yourself.
Remember appearance first, remember name. Okay. Right. Man, could that be this one? Yeah, dude. Download. No. I misread, apparently. Yeah, this dude is gonna be awesome. I don't want show scars. Yes. Face paint. Yes. All right, dude. What? Man. I think this is badass. What is this crap? Really? Hmm. All right. Okay, confirm. Enter name. Glimmer man? I have no idea. I don't even know what that means. Alright. Do you want to quit the game? No? I do wanna confirm. Codename. I don't know. Codename. Rock. Oh, damn it. Rock solid. All right. One or more unusable.
Yeah, that's what you look like.
All right, so 12 minutes in.
We can finally meet.
And we have only made ourselves a very handsome glimmer man, whatever that means. Wow, look at me, I'm awesome. Alright, so rested mistle. Alright. Perry? Okay. Alright. Hey man.
We finally meet. Are you clear-headed?
Do I not look clear-headed?
As an immortal creature, a revenant. There are things you will need to know in your new life, so listen well.
Oh, now it's installed. What?
Each revenant has a different power coursing through their veins, called a blood cook. The best way to learn about it is to try it for yourself.
Alright, 8:45. Revenants possess special powers known as blood codes. Depending on the specific blood code, a revenant status will differ. To view these stats, select the currently equipped blood code on this menu screen. Greenslayer blade, Queenslayer hammer, Queenslayer claw. Right. Can't do anything here. Passive effects on off. Okay. Switch display. Passive health boost. Active adrenaline blood card. Focus stamina.
That is a fighter blood code, which is excellent for combat. Each talent that a blood code bestows is known as a gift. The fighter blood code grants ever-increasing endurance. It seems you also have a gift that temporarily enhances your attack power. Try it out.
Try equipping adrenaline. Right. Try equipping adrenaline. Spend your own HP to restore. Unleash a combo on a nearby. Right?
Very well. Give it a try.
Try using adrenaline. R2. R2 plus R2?
Yes, that will do.
Oh, I had to go.
Be warned. The effects of a gift will not work unless it is prepared in advance. I forgot something important.
Okay.
You will need special blood to activate gifts. This blood comes from revenants who have forgotten themselves and turned into monsters. The Lost.
Right.
You can drain Ichor from the Lost by striking them with your weapon. Remember that. Those are the basics of a fighter's gifts. Use and learn each of them well.
Lock to an enemy. All right. Alright, I got it. Oh, I didn't really check out. Wait a second, what is that? Regeneration. Okay. Hey, dude.
Well done. Ordinarily, a revenant has only one blood code. But you are different. The blood code you once held was broken and has vanished. That has left you with infinite possibilities. You have the unique talent to change your blood code. Come, look deep within yourself.
Ranger, code owner unknown. This code excels at providing support and defense buffs. Support and defense, right? Oh, there you go. Right, so HP is down. Stamina is up. Base mobility, quick, weight limit. Attack is down, total weight is down. Attack is seriously down on weapon 2, man. Wow. Mobility is slow, in a way. Gift light? Gift dark? Drain attack is up. Blood, fire, ice, defense. It's not up that much, I mean, one. So, yeah. Oh, do I really have to? No longer meet the stat requirements too efficiently.
That blood code is known as Ranger. Oh dear, that weapon seems to be too heavy for them. Rangers are nimble and best at fighting with light weaponry.
Okay.
Try switching to a bayonet.
Alright, so where's the... Each piece of equipment has stats requirement and weight. Exceeding your weight limit restricts your ability to dodge attack. Open field. Equipment can be changed from the menu screen. Alright, so we have the hammer and the... Can't? I can't. Both the main weapon and the sub-weapon can be equipped. These weapons can be switched without opening. Switch between main and sub-weapon. There you go. Okay.
Oh, firing your bayonet requires Ichor as well. That and gifts means Ichor always seems scared. That is where the blood veil you have equipped comes in. Using your blood veil will let you quickly drain Ichor from the lost. In addition, this can increase the amount of Ichor you can hold. If you have a chance to drain Ichor from a foe, use it.
Okay. Oh, all right. Holy shit. Okay. Come on, man. Are we serious about this? All right, what happened here? Okay. Yeah, so yeah, okay. Covain is fucked up. Huh. In the introduction, man, what? So are you kidding me? And I'm gonna try online mode this time.
Finally meet. You will
bear
each of
the- Check blood code. Yes.
That is a fighter blood code, which is XE the fits.
I've done this already. Try equipping adrenaline.
Very well. Yes, that will do. Be warned. The effect I thought is you could.
Gotcha.
Well done, ordered that you.
Ranger.
That blood code is known as Rotier Ranger.
Yeah, this one.
Yes, that's much better, isn't it? Oh, that is used in it if you.
Aha! Alright, drink deep. Alright, are we.
That sums up the Ranger blood code and drainery.
Cool.
Let us try one more blood code.
Yes.
Now, turn your gaze inward.
Caster specializes in powerful attack type gifts that can be used from a distance. You acquire a new blood code. Alright, we're gonna try and change. Caster. Which is, wait a second here. Okay, so
that
I can't.
Is what is called the caster blood code. Casters possess powers like magic from a fairy tale. With it, you can use gifts to fire projectiles of blood.
Alright. try using bloodshot. Right.
Nice. You learn quickly. Bloodshot favors range over power. Let's see. Try learning another gift. You can learn gifts by touching missiles. Try it yourself.
Can be learned. So what? This can't be learned? Okay, so only this. Blazing roar. Shots an intense flame at the target. You discover the gift latent potential. Once you become a proliferator with the gift, you will unlock the ability to inherit it. Okay. Max out. Do you want to use haste and the required materials to unlock the ability to inherit?
That wasn't hard, was it? Now since you've learned it, why not try it out?
Gift assignment to be saved.
Gift that punishes foes. However, Its cost and ichor. In addition, its power will change according to the blood veil you equip. Blood veils have different affinities or gifts. It can be complicated, but keep it in mind.
Sweet.
Excellent work. It's all quite sudden, but you picked it up, right?
Yeah, I mean...
The disappearance of your blood code has left you with unique, limitless capabilities. Not only can you change blood codes, but you can acquire new ones as well. The strength of others can become your own. A talent that you alone possess.
Yeah, that's sweet. Since but I do need to...
You can do this.
To get more stamina, ASAP. Alright, are we done with the introduction? Can we start the game now? I feel like I have control of the situation. Maybe, I don't know. I mean, those first guys, I can surely handle them. Revenants were created by implanting an engineered BOR parasite into the heart of a human corpse. By holding the parasite's invasion at a certain level, hosts were able to maintain their own volition. Alright, my eyelids are starting to work. I feel like there's a short cutscene here and then we're on our way. So we're already at 32 minutes, and that's because of the fuck up with the game at the introduction, and,
Hello. How are you feeling?
I'm feeling awesome! How are you feeling? Also, I look awesome. Yeah, it's not the greatest, animation here, but... Oh man, I look sad.
Don't worry. It's okay. I don't remember either. Over there.
Over there is what? Oh, it's the tree. Well, I'm not gonna go over there. I feel like... What? Come on. Well, anyway, let's wrap this up and we'll start over in the next episode. Thank you very much for watching this one. This is gonna be a blast, so keep on watching. I'm Oscar Moon, and as always, I'm out.